Hello and welcome to a very basic tutorial of isometric design. This video is about how to create an isometric grid using one line segment. First, we take an artboard of 1080 by 1080 pixels. So we got a squared shape artboard here. Now take the line segment and draw a single vertical line here. Select line segment tool, click and drag. Make sure you hold shift button so you get a straight line here. So we have got a line. If we drag it to the artboard so we can see it clearly. So here to make a grid, we definitely need more lines. So for that, what we are gonna do is hold alt shift and drag it so we can duplicate it this way. If we see closer, so we have got another line segment. Now we press Ctrl D to make other copies. Keep pressing and we've got multiple lines. Select them all, right click and group. Align them to the artboard. Here, select this group, go to rotate tool, double click, set the angle to 60 degrees, make sure preview is on and hit copy. So we have got a copy of the same group. Now keep it selected and double click the rotate tool again. Same angle, 60 degrees, preview on and another copy. All done. We have got our isometric grid. The usable grid is the area within the artboard. So we don't need extra lines which are out of the artboard. This pattern is going to be used to make different isometric shapes. Select them all. Right click and group. Take the rectangle tool, set the stroke to fill and take a rectangle of 1080 by 1080 pixels. Hit OK. And we've got a rectangle. The artboard. OK. And now select both of the objects, right click and make clipping mask. There you go. Your isometric grid is ready. Now, for the further assistance, let me tell you that we are going to use this isometric grid in the next tutorials to make different isometric shapes. First, we will start with some basic shapes and then we'll move to the complex ones. So, for staying tuned to know how to use this isometric grid, just subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon so you will be notified for the next video very soon. Watch full video and keep practicing to get a perfect isometric grid. In the next video, we are going to make some basic isometric shapes and then we'll move to the complex ones. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video soon.